Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the solution and discussion on gate question paper in Mechanical Engineering subject. And this is lecture number 14. The topic is gas power cycle, and we are going to discuss the questions from auto cycle from various gate question paper. And these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering subjects: design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the above subjects, and also I am uploading the solutions for gate question papers in mechanical engineering subjects. The mechanical engineering students, so please subscribe the channel and use the video lectures for your better learning and pass in the gate examination, because gate examination is going to be mandatory for engineering graduates in future, or any national level examination will be conducted to qualify yourself as mechanical engineer. And this question is from 1996 question paper. A cycle consisting of two reversible isothermal process and two reversible isobaric process is known as Atkinson cycle, Stirling cycle, Brayton cycle and Erickson cycle. And two reversible isothermal process and two reversible isobaric process. The cycle is shown in the PV and TS diagram, and the name of the cycle is Erickson cycle. So Erickson cycle consists of two isothermal processes. So 1 to 2 isothermal expansion, 2 to 3 constant pressure cooling, and 3 to 4 isothermal compression, and 4 to 1 constant pressure heating. Which one of the following is not necessary assumption for the air standard auto cycle? All the processes are both internally and externally reversible. Second option, intake and exhaust processes are constant volume heat addition processes. The combustion process is constant volume heat addition process. And the working fluid is an ideal gas with the constant specific heats. So for an auto cycle, all the processes are both internally and externally reversible. That is correct. The intake and exhaust process are constant volume heat addition process. So that is irrelevant assumption. That is irrelevant statement available here. And other two assumptions: combustion process is constant volume heat addition process, and working fluid is an ideal gas with the constant specific heat. So the irrelevant or the not incorrect statement is intake and exhaust process are constant volume heat addition, statement B. This is from 2008 question paper. The next question is from 1989 question paper. In an air standard auto cycle, the terminal pressures at the end of compression, heat release, expansion are P2, P3, P4. So end of compression P2, end of heat addition P3, and end of expansion P4 respectively. If the corresponding values are P2, P3, and P4, taking into account the effect of variable specific heat and dissociation of working fluid, then we have four options. P2 is less than P2 and P3 is greater than P3. P3 is less than P3 and P4 is greater than P4. P2 is greater than P2 and P3 is greater than P3 and P4 is less than P4. And P2 is greater than P2 and P3 is greater than P3. So you look at the diagram. This is the pressure volume diagram for auto cycle. So 1, 2, 3, 4 black color line, that is what the regular cycle, and the deviation is shown here. So 1 to 2 dash, 4 to 3 dash. So 3 to 3 dash, there is the deviation. So for the auto cycle, the correct statement is P2 is greater than P2 and P3 is greater than P3. That is the correct statement for the auto cycle. The figure below shows the thermodynamic cycle undergone by a certain system. Find the mean effective pressure in kilopascal. So look at the diagram. We have a PV diagram. It's a triangle, and the P1, V1, P2, V2 values are given here. So P1 equal to 200 kilopascal, P2 equal to 500 kilopascal, V1 equal to 0.01 meter cube, and V2 equal to 0.03 meter cube. So work done equal to area of the triangle. So area of the triangle for a triangle half BH. So half into B is minus 0.03 minus 0.01, and H equal to 500 minus 200, which is 3 kilonewton meter. So mean effective pressure equal to work done by swept volume. So work done equal to 3 divided by 0.03 minus 0.01 equal to 150 kilopascal. So the mean effective pressure of the cycle is 150 kilopascal. And this question is from 2001 question paper. In a spark ignition engine working on ideal auto cycle, the compression ratio is 5.5. The work output per cycle is equal to 23.625 into 10 power 5 Vc in joules, where Vc is the clearance volume in meter cube. The indicated mean effective pressure is, there are four options: 4.295 bar, 5.25 bar, 86.87 bar, 106.3 bar. So the auto cycle is shown here in the PV diagram. So V1 is the volume before the compression, and V2 is the volume after the compression. And the indicated mean effective pressure, work done divided by the swept volume. Swept volume is V1 minus V2. So work done divided by, I take V2 outside. So V2 into V1 by V2 minus 1. So V1 by V2 equal to R, and V2 is the clearance volume. So here V2 equal to the clearance volume. So Vc into R minus 1. So indicated mean effective pressure equal to 23.625 into 10 power 5 into Vc divided by Vc into R minus 1 equal to 23.625 into 10 power 5 divided by 5.5 minus 1, which is equal to 5.25 into 10 power 5 Pascal, or 5.25 bar. So the correct answer is 5.25 bar. The next question is from 2002 question paper. An ideal air standard auto cycle has the compression ratio of 8.5. If the ratio of specific heat of air is 1.4, what is the thermal efficiency of the auto cycle in percentage? There are four options: 57.5%, 45.7%, 52.5%, and 95%. So the efficiency of the auto cycle is 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1 minus 1 by 8.5 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.575, is 57.5%. So the correct answer is 57.5%, option A. The next question is from 2003 question paper. For an engine operating on air standard auto cycle, the clearance volume is 10% of the swept volume. The specific heat ratio of air is 1.4. The air standard efficiency of the cycle is, again there are four options: 38.3%, 39.8%, 60.2%, and 61.7%. So we have to calculate here the compression ratio, which is Vs plus Vc divided by Vc. So Vs plus point Vc equal to 10% of the swept volume. So Vc equal to 0.1 into Vs divided by again 0.1 into Vs. So Vs is getting cancelled. The numerator is 1.1 divided by 0.1. So equal to 11. So the compression ratio is 11. So the efficiency of the auto cycle, eta equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1 minus 1 by 11 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.617. which is 61.7%. So the correct answer is option D, 61.7%. The next question is from 2004 question paper. An engine working on air standard auto cycle has a cylinder diameter of 10 cm and the stroke length 15 cm. The ratio of specific heats for air is 1.4. The clearance volume is 196.3 cc, and the heat supplied per kg of air per cycle is 1800 kilojoules per kilogram. The work output per cycle per kg of air is, there are four options again: 879.1 kilojoules, 890.2 kilojoules, 895.3 kilojoules and 973.5 kilojoules. So we calculate the swept volume, stroke volume, pi by 4 d square into L. So pi by 4 into 0.1 square into 0.15 equal to 1.1775 in 10 power minus 3 meter square. So we calculate the compression ratio Vs plus Vc divided by Vc. So the Vs equal to 1.1775 in 10 power minus 3 and Vc equal to 196.3 cc. So 193.3 into 10 power minus 6. So cubic centimeter to meter cube. So 10 power minus 6 divided by Vc again 196.3 in 10 power minus 6. So calculating R equal to 7. So the eta efficiency of the Otto cycle 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1 minus 1 by 7 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.5408. So W equal to eta into QS. So efficiency into heat supplied. So equal to 0.5408 into 1800 equal to 973.44 kilojoules. And the correct answer is option D, 973.5 kilojoules. The next question from 2005 question paper. A reversible thermodynamic cycle containing only three processes and producing work is to be constructed. The constraints are, there must be one isothermal process, there must be one isentropic process, and maximum minimum cycle pressures and clearance volumes are fixed. Polytropic process is not allowed. Then number of cycles possible, four options, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I read the statement once again. We have to use isothermal process, isentropic process, constant pressure process, and constant volume process. So these four processes we have to use in multiple combination, and polytropic process is not allowed. So by using one isothermal, there must be one isothermal, one isentropic, and the constant volume, constant pressure process. So how many cycles are possible? So the answer is four. And we will see how in the next slide. So cycle 1, isothermal process, isentropic process, and a constant volume process. Cycle 2, isothermal process, isentropic process, and constant pressure process. Cycle 3, isentropic process, constant volume process, and constant pressure process. Cycle 4, isothermal process, constant volume process, and constant pressure process. So the cycles possibles are 4. That is the answer mentioned in the previous slide. And this question is from 2006 question paper. Group 1 shows the different heat addition processes. Group 2 shows the of the cycle. Group 2 shows the different heat removal process. And group 3 lists the power cycles. Match the item from group 1, 2 and 3. So group 1 heat addition process. Group 2 heat removal process, and group 3 is the cycle. Different cycle, Rankine cycle, Otto cycle, Carnot cycle, Diesel cycle, Barreton cycle. So the group 1 heat addition, it may be constant temperature, constant volume, constant pressure. Heat removal, again it may be constant pressure, constant volume, or constant temperature. And I have grouped. So, group 1, heat addition, constant pressure, constant volume, temperature is constant. Group 2, constant pressure, constant volume, and temperature is constant. And I grouped the two cycles, Rankine cycle, Barreton cycle. They have constant pressure heat addition, constant pressure heat removal. Otto cycle, constant volume heat addition, constant pressure heat removal. Carnot cycle, constant temperature heat addition and constant temperature heat removal. But Diesel cycle, constant pressure heat addition, constant volume heat removal. So that is also possible. But here look at the combination. First option, PS5. What is PS5? Constant pressure heat addition, constant pressure heat removal, and 5 is the Barreton cycle. So the statement is true. RU3, R is constant temperature heat addition, U is constant temperature heat removal, and 3 is Carnot cycle. That statement is also correct. PS1. So P is constant pressure heat addition, S is constant pressure heat addition, constant pressure heat removal, 1 is Rankine cycle. That is also correct. QT2. So Q is constant volume heat addition, T is constant volume heat removal and 2 is the Otto cycle. That is also correct. So, option A, all the 4 combinations are correct. Option B, PS1. So, PS1, constant pressure heat addition, constant pressure heat removal, Rankine cycle. RU3, R, temperature, constant temperature heat addition, constant temperature heat removal, 3, Carnot cycle. That is also correct. PS4, constant pressure heat addition, constant pressure heat removal, 4, diesel cycle. That is not correct. So, option B is dropped. RT1, so R, constant temperature heat addition, constant volume heat removal, 1, Rankine cycle. That is wrong. PTC is wrong. PT4, P is constant pressure heat addition, T is constant volume heat removal, and 1, Rankine cycle. That's it. 4, diesel cycle. That is correct. PT4 is correct. RS3, R, constant temperature heat addition, constant pressure heat removal, Carnot cycle. That is not correct. So, the correct answer is A. All the 4 statements, all the 4 combinations are possible. So, other cases, they have 1 or 2 wrong combination, the options are dropped. Next question from 2007 question paper. The stroke and bore of a 4-stroke spark ignition engine are 250 mm and 200 mm respectively. The clearance volume is 0.001 m³. If the specific heat ratio is 1.4, the air standard efficiency of the engine is 46.4%, 56.1%, 58.2% and 62.8%. And we calculate the stroke volume, pi by 4 d square into L, pi by 4 into 0.2 square into stroke length is 0.25 equal to 7.85 in 10 power minus 3 meter cube, and compression ratio is Vs plus Vc divided by Vc, 7.85 in 10 power minus 3 plus 0.001 divided by 0.001 equal to 8.85, and the efficiency equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1 minus 1 by 8.85 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.582, which is 58.2%. So, the option C is correct answer, 58.2%. Next question is from 2007 question paper. A thermodynamic cycle with an ideal gas working fluid is shown below. So, this is the thermodynamic cycle in PV coordinate. So, the volume 1 meter cube here, V2 equal to 1 meter cube, V1 equal to, it is unknown, V1 is unknown. So, P2 equal to P1 equal to 100 kilopascal, P3 equal to 400 kilopascal. The first question, there are 2 questions here. First question, the TS diagram of the above cycle. So, looking at the TS diagram, there are 4 options A, B, C, D. We look at A, 1 to 2, constant pressure heat removal. So, the volume is decreasing, constant pressure heat removal. 2 to 3, sorry, constant volume, constant pressure. 2 to 3, constant volume heat addition. So, volume is constant, pressure is increasing. And 3 to 1, PV to the power gamma equal to constant. So, this is adiabatic process. So, 1 to 2, constant pressure heat removal, 2 to 3, constant volume heat addition, and 3 to 1, adiabatic expansion. So, first cycle, 1 to 2, temperature decreases, entropy increases. It is irrelevant. When the temperature decreases, entropy should decrease. So, the cycle is wrong. Option B, diagram B, there is no 1 to 2, there is 2 to 1. So, this is also wrong. Option C is, B is wrong. Option C, 1 to 2, constant pressure heat removal. So, temperature decreases, entropy is also decreasing. 2 to 3, constant volume heat addition. Temperature increases, entropy is also increasing. 3 to 1, constant entropy process. PV to the power gamma, adiabatic, constant entropy process. Option C is correct. So, the correct answer is C. So, the corresponding temperature entropy diagram for the PV diagram is C. The next question here, in the previous section, in the previous question, if the specific heat of the working fluid are constant and the value of the specific heat ratio is 1.4, the thermal efficiency of the cycle, we have 4 options, 21%, 40.9%, 42.6%, 59.7%. it is Lennoyer cycle with Lennoyer cycle, and its efficiency is given by 1 minus gamma into rp to the power 1 by gamma minus 1 divided by rp minus 1, which is equal to 1 minus 1.4 into rp, pressure ratio. Pressure ratio of the cycle, look at the diagram. Pressure ratio equal to P3 by P2 equal to 400 by 100, which is 4. So, 4 to the power 1 by 1.4 minus 1 divided by 4 minus 1 equal to 0.21, 21%. So, the answer is 21%. The next question is from 2007 question paper. In an air standard auto cycle, the compression ratio is 10. The condition at the beginning of the cycle is 100 kilopascal and 27 degrees Celsius. The heat added at constant volume is 1500 kilojoules per kg and heat rejected is 700 kilojoules per kg. The specific gas constant is 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and the mean effective pressure of the cycle is, four options are given, 103 kilopascal, 310 kilopascal, 515 kilopascal, 1032 kilopascal. So, we calculate from the initial conditions, we calculate the specific volume at inlet beginning RT1 by P1 equal to 0.287 into 300 divided by 100 equal to 0.861 meter cube per kilogram. And V2 from the definition of compression ratio, V2 equal to V1 by R, which is 0.861 divided by 10 equal to 0.0861 meter cube per kilogram. So, the mean effective pressure equal to work done divided by the swept volume. So, work done equal to net heat transfer. So, 1500 minus 700 divided by 0.861 minus 0.0861 equal to 1032.4 kilopascal. So, the answer is 1032.4 kilopascal, option D. The next question is from 2012 question paper. The crank radius of a single cylinder IC engine is 60 mm and the diameter of the cylinder is 80 mm. The swept volume of the cylinder in centimeter cube is 48, 96, 302, 603. So, we calculate the swept volume. The stroke length equal to 2 times of the crank radius. So, 2 into 6 equal to 12 cm. Diameter equal to 8 cm. So, the swept volume is pi by 4 d square into L. So, pi by 4 into 8 square into 12 equal to 603 cm cube. So, the answer is 603, option D. The next question paper is from 2014 question paper. In an air standard auto cycle, the air is supplied at 0.1 megapascal and 308 Kelvin. The ratio of specific heat and specific gas constant are 1.4 and 288.8 joules per kilogram Kelvin, respectively. If the compression ratio is 8 and the maximum temperature of the cycle is 2660 Kelvin, the heat supplied in kilojoules per kilogram to the engine is dash. So, from the given data, we have to calculate the T2, temperature after the compression. So, T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1. So, T2 by T1 equal to V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1. So, V1 by V2 equal to R. So, 308 into 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 707.6 Kelvin. So, heat supplied. So, auto cycle heat supplied equal to Cv into T3 minus T2. So, Cv equal to R by gamma minus 1. So, into T3 minus T2. So, substituting 0.2888 in kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin divided by 1.4 minus 1 into 2660 minus 707.6 equal to 1409.6 kilojoules per kilogram. So, the answer is 1409.6 kilojoules per kilogram, the heat supplied. And next question is from 2018 question paper. An engine working on air standard auto cycle is supplied with air at 0.1 megapascal and temperature 35 degrees Celsius. The compression ratio is 8. The heat supplied is 500 kilojoules per kilogram. The property data of air, Cp equal to 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and Cv equal to 0.718 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and R equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. The maximum temperature of the cycle is dash. Correct to 2 decimal places. So, T2 we calculate from the given data. T2 equal to T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1. So, 308 into 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 707.6. And QS equal to Cv into T3 minus T2. So, QS heat supplied is given as 500 kilojoules. So, 500 equal to 0.718 into T3 minus 707.6. So, calculating from this equation T3 equal to 1403.98 Kelvin. So, the temperature is 1403.98 Kelvin. Next question is from 2018 question paper. A vehicle is powered with a spark ignition engine, follows air standard auto cycle with gamma equal to 1.4. The engine generates 70 kilowatts while consuming 10.3 kilojoules per hour of fuel. The calorific value of the fuel is 44,000 kilojoules per kilogram. The compression ratio is dash, correct to 2 decimal places. So, the eta equal to power by heat supplied. So, power equal to 70 kilowatts divided by heat supplied equal to mass of the fuel and the calorific value. 10.3 divided by 3600 into 44,000. So, eta equal to 5.556. So, efficiency equal to 1 minus 1 by r to the power gamma minus 1. So, substituting left hand side, eta equal to 0.556 equal to 1 minus 1 by r to the power 1.4 minus 1. So, r to the power 0.4 equal to 1 minus 0.556 equal to 0.444. So, calculating r equal to 7.61. So, the answer is 7.61. Compression ratio is 7.61. Next question from 2019 question paper. An air standard auto cycle has thermal efficiency of 0.5 and the mean effective pressure of the cycle is 1000 kilopascal. For air, assuming specific heat ratio 1.4 and specific gas constant 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. If the pressure and temperature at the beginning of the compression stroke are 100 kilopascal and 300 Kelvin respectively, then the specific net work output of the cycle in dash kilojoules per kilogram. So, it is answer is 709 kilojoules per kilogram. We will see how in the slide. So, efficiency is given. Efficiency equal to 0.5. So, 1 minus 1 by r to the power gamma minus 1 equal to 0.5. So, rearranging and calculating r equal to 5.66. The compression ratio is 5.66. And we calculate specific volume at the inlet RT1 by P1. So, 0.287 into 300 divided by 100 equal to 0.861. And V2 equal to V1 by R equal to 0.861 divided by 5.66 equal to 0.152 meter cube per kilogram. So, mean effective pressure equal to work done by septal volume V1 minus V2. So, work done equal to mean effective pressure into V1 minus V2. So, 1000 into 0.861 minus 0.152 equal to 709 kilojoules. That is the answer. So, we marked in the previous slide. So, 709 kilojoules per kilogram. The next question from 1994 question paper, an air standard auto cycle has a volumetric compression ratio of 6. Lowest cycle pressure is 0.1 megapascal and the operates between the temperature of 27 degrees Celsius and 1569 degrees Celsius. There are three questions. Calculate the temperature and pressure after the isentropic expansion. Ratio of specific heat equal to 1.4. Option next question B, since it is observed that the value are well above the lowest cycle operating condition, the expansion process allowed to continue down to pressure 0.1 megapascal. Which process is required to complete the cycle? Name the cycle obtained. Question number C, determine by what percentage cycle efficiency has been improved. So, the first question is auto cycle. Second question is cycle is modified, so you have to identify the name of the cycle. And third question, so first cycle auto cycle, second cycle some new cycle, we have to find out the efficiency of both cycles and we have to find the improvement in the efficiency, percentage of increase in the efficiency. So, for auto cycle, so the PVTS diagram are given here, we are given R equal to compression ratio equal to 6, P1 equal to 0.1 megapascal. T1 equal to 27 degrees Celsius, which is 1300 Kelvin. T3 equal to 1569 degrees Celsius, which is 1842 Kelvin. So, we calculate the properties. T2 equal to T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1. So, 300 into 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 61.4.4. P2 equal to P1 into R to the power gamma, which is 0.1 into 6 to the power 1.4 equal to 1.228 megapascal. P3 equal to P2 into T3 by T2 for constant volume heat addition process. So, 1.228 into 1842 divided by 614.4 equal to 3.68 megapascal. T4 equal to T3 by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is equal to 1842 divided by 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1, which is 899.6 Kelvin. And P4 equal to P3 by r to the power gamma equal to 3.68 divided by 6 to the power 1.4 equal to 0.3 megapascal. So, what is required here? We have to calculate the efficiency for the part A. The efficiency of the cycle 1 minus 1 by r to the power gamma minus 1 equal to 1 minus 6 to the power 1 by 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.512. So, answer the efficiency of the auto the answer the final pressure P4 equal to 300 kilopascal and temperature equal to 899.6 Kelvin. So, the P4 and T4 we have to calculate. So, this is the first question. So, look at the first question once again. Calculate the temperature and the pressure after the isentropic expansion. We have calculated P4 and T4. The second cycle, second question, it is observed that the values are well above the lowest cycle operating condition. So, lowest cycle operating condition is 0.1 megapascal and 27 degree Celsius. The expansion process allowed to continue down to the pressure 0.1 megapascal. So, we have to continue the expansion process. And what is the cycle and name the cycle. So, here this is the Otto cycle and here we calculated P4 equal to 0.3 megapascal. P1 is given as 0.1 megapascal. Now, we have to extend the 4 to 0.1 megapascal. Now, what is the cycle? The cycle is Atkinson cycle. So, P4 is extended to P5 which is equal to 0.1 megapascal. So, for Atkinson cycle, the expansion ratio we have to calculate. The new cycle is Atkinson cycle and the efficiency of the new cycle expansion process Re equal to V5 by V3 which is P3 by P4 to the power 1 by gamma which is 3.68 divided by 0.1 to the power 1 by 1.4 equal to 13.13. So, expansion ratio. So, 3 to 5 is the expansion. Now, the efficiency of Atkinson cycle eta A equal to 1 minus gamma into Re minus R divided by Re to the power gamma minus R to the power gamma. So, R is the compression ratio. So, 1 to 2 is the compression ratio and we require now 1 minus 1.4 into 13.3 minus 6 divided by 13.3 to the power 1.4 minus 6 to the power 1.4 equal to 0.592. So, efficiency of Atkinson cycle. And efficiency of Otto cycle we calculated earlier 0.512. So, now the question C, increase in efficiency. So, that is equal to efficiency of Atkinson cycle minus efficiency of Otto cycle divided by efficiency of Otto cycle into 100 equal to. So, substitute the numerical values 0.592 minus 0.512 divided by 0.512 into 100 equal to 15.6%. So, increase in efficiency. The next question is from 1998 question paper. The minimum pressure and temperature of an Otto cycle are 100 kilopascal and 27 degree Celsius. The amount of heat added to the cycle is 1500 kilojoules per kilogram. Determine the pressure temperature at all points of the Otto cycle. Also calculate the specific work and thermal efficiency of the cycle for a compression ratio of 8 and CV equal to 0.72, gamma equal to 1.4. And the efficiency equal to 1 minus 1 by r to the power gamma minus 1 which is 1 minus 1 by 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.565 which is 56.5%. Work done equal to eta into heat transfer that is equal to 0.565 into 1500 equal to 847.5 kilojoules per kilogram. So, the second part of the question, calculate the specific work and thermal efficiency are calculated here. And determine the pressure and temperature at all points of the Otto cycle. We'll see in the next slide. So, T2 equal to T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1 which is 300 into 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 689.2 Kelvin. P2 equal to P1 into R to the power gamma which is 100 into 8 to the power 1.4 equal to 1837.9 kilopascal. And T3 equal to T2 plus Q by CV. So, 689.2 plus 1500 divided by 0.72 equal to 2772.5 Kelvin and P3 equal to P2 into T3 by T2 for constant volume process 1837.9 into 2772.5 divided by 689.2 equal to 7393.5 kilopascal and for expansion process T4 equal to T3 by R to the power gamma minus 1. So, 2772.5 divided by 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 1206.8 Kelvin and the P4 pressure at the end of expansion P4 equal to P3 by R to the power gamma which is 7393.8 divided by 8 to the power 1.4 equal to 402.3 kilopascal. So these are all the pressure temperature at different points of the Otto cycle. So we stop here. So these are all the questions on the Otto cycle. So thank you for watching, and you can please post your comments on the YouTube comments box if you have any comments, and you subscribe the channel so that you will get the updated videos on the GATE question paper and mechanical engineering subject. And you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. I will sincerely answer. So thank you for watching. We'll meet again with another video on problems on GATE question paper.